Hello guys, welcome back to my channel Rahul Automation Studio. So today in this video we are going to learn how you can run your test suite or test suite collection from the command line interface from your CMD. So first of all, you have to open the project in your Catalan Studio and you have to create the test suite or test suite collection. If you don't know how to create test suite or test suite collection, you can see my different videos for that. So if you have already created test suite and test suite collection, so let's start how you can create and run your test suite collections or test suite from the command line. So first of all, you can see this icon. This is our CMD, which we'll be using to generate the command line for your test suite or test suite collection. Just click on this icon. So after opening this icon, you can see you can select the test suite from the browse button. So all the test suite or test suite collection which you have created, you can select from here. So like suppose you have to generate a command from this for this particular test suite, you have to select this. If and execution environment, you can run with the different browsers, so you can always edit and select the browser in which you want to run your test suite. You can also change the profile, because if there are multiple environments that you have created and you want to execute your test suite in particular staging environment or some different environment, so based on that you can select your profile as well. So next is the API authentications, and you can see these are the mandatory that is required for your command line. So API key must be specified to activate your runtime engine online, and Catalan runtime engine required for the console node execution. So if you're executing, running your test suite from the console mode, then Catalan runtime engine is mandatory in your system. So before Catalan Studio like 7, so it was not mandatory Catalan runtime engine. But after Catalan 7, Catalan runtime engine is mandatory for your system. So how you can download this Catalan runtime engine? So you have to go to the Catalan website. You have to log in with your account details. So like that. So you have to go to product, click on view all products. After that, you have to come down. You can see once our scripting is done, you have to do the execution. For the execution, you need to require this Catalan runtime engine, and there is availability for free trial. You have to click on this. Once you will click, you can see there is a runtime engine and you can download according to your requirement, like Windows 32-bit for Mac OS or Linux, and you can start downloading. So after download, you have to do the unzip and you have to put all these files under one particular folder where you want to add. So I have already downloaded and unzip in my particular one folder. So once you complete and download the setup for this Catalan runtime engine, you have to generate the command for your test suite. So test suite, you have to select browsers, and you can also do the execution configurations like update the web driver automatically. You should always check this box, because you don't know when your Chrome browser is updated or you need to update a web driver accordingly, so that your test case don't get failed. So just always click on this checkbox. You can and apply proxy configurations from the application settings. You can also give the retry count if test cases are failing. So you can always give the retry count, how many times you want to re-execute the test case. So after that, you have to click on the generate commands. Once you click on the generate command, it will give you the command for your particular test suite. In the same way, you can also do for your Catalan test suite collections. So this is our test suite collection. You have to click on OK. And then in the same way, all the configurations are like same. You have to click on generate command. So this is our command for the test suite collection. So we will be using and we will be running for the particular test suite. So just select a test suite and generate a command for that. You have to copy the commands. You can do the copy like this, or you can click on copy to clipboard. So once you click on copy to clipboard, close it. You can also close this, and we are closing the complete catalog UI for it. So once you have copied your command, so you have to come to the particular directory where you have unzip and put your Catalog Ninja folder. So just click on there, type cmd, open a command from there. You have to paste the command lines which you have copied and just click on enter. So after that, once you click on the enter, it will start the execution for your test suite, and it will not open even Catalog UI. So what are the different advantages of this by running your test suite from the command line? So first of all, it is not opening your Catalog UI, so your execution will be fast, and it will be consuming the less memory also for you. And this is required for your continuous testing as well, right? So, and it is also help in while integrating with the different plugins, different continuous testing plugins like Jenkins, Bamboo, Docker, right? So without the command line, you will not be able to integrate and run your test suite from the Jenkins or Docker. They required a command lines for that. So it is very helpful. So in that, it will automatically login as our Catalog requires a login and activate the Catalog. So it will automatically do for you. So it is starting the execution for you. You will see it will automatically open the Chrome browser as we are running in a Chrome. So our test case execution is started. So our test case is completed in the Catalog test suite. So it will now generate a test report for you, and it will automatically upload this report in your Catalog desktops for the further test analysis. So you can see the generated report also. So in your folder, in your project folder, we will be opening the Catalog. And I will show you the execution report as well from the command line interface. So it will generate the same report. There will be no difference in the report. So the same report you can use for your management and for the analysis purpose. So our test case and test suite execution is completed. All the launchers are terminated. You can close this command prompt. It is opening the project for you. So in the report folder, you can see the report is there, and you can see it is executed on the 16/10/2021, and the time is 10:50. So recent only. So it is the updated one. We have executed catalog_login test suite. Just open the containing folder, and you can see there is the report, and we will be opening the report. So you can see our test case has been passed, and the name of the test suite is catalon_login. And this is our test case name, testcase_catalon_login, and all the steps are passed in that. So like the same way, you can also execute your test suite collection and it will automatically generate reports for you. So thank you guys. Please like, share and subscribe my videos. Thank you all. Bye.